We're here with Joe Masserino from Fujitsu Network Communications, and we're talking about all things 5G. Hi, Joe. Welcome.
Great. Hey, Sterling.
So let's probably start from challenges. Operators moving from today's 4G LTE, looking to move to 5G tomorrow. There's obviously a lot of challenges out there. What, from your discussions, what do you see as the main challenges they face?
Right, there's a lot of diverse challenges that operators are facing. The deployment of not only big bandwidth, but also low latency use case applications and scalable architectures that provide efficiency throughout the life cycle of the network. These all brought together while maintaining a level of connectivity throughout the network without eliminating overlays within the network and still providing backhaul or back compatibility with the overall network architecture that you have in place.
So I know Fujitsu has been talking a lot about open 5G architectures. Can you maybe talk a little bit about what Fujitsu's position and commitment are around open 5G?
Sure. With open architectures, Fujitsu is involved in several industry organizations, including the O-RAN Alliance. We have an open architecture system that is open protocol, open domain, offering a workflow design that is very easy and seamless to implement. We have open APIs throughout the entire architecture as well.
So a lot of commitment and a lot of different organizations to kind of help drive that forward.
Yes, exactly.
For standards, essentially. So looking at products, Fujitsu has this smart xHaul solution. I think it's kind of an umbrella of different products. Maybe give a little bit of overview of what exactly is the smart xHaul.
So for the past few years, we've been deploying our smart xHaul solution. This includes a WDM-based solution that covers the fronthaul, midhaul, backhaul networks. There's over 2,600 network elements that have been shipped to date with this architecture. They're installed in many 4G C-RAN networks and even some of the very few 5G networks that have been installed to date. They offer coexistence with 4G and 5G, so they're fully managed networks and implemented over a very scalable solution set.
So what, 5G, you talked a little bit already about the challenges and the changes required. How does Smart xHaul evolve as a product line for 5G?
Sure. So our existing WDM solution also supports 5G, so you can have coexistence with 4G and 5G. But with 5G and the big bandwidths and diverse use cases that are being implemented, there is a level of virtualization that's needed. So we have evolved our smart xHaul system to include new technologies that address these new capabilities that are going to be needed. And those new technologies include time-sensitive networking and O-RAN Alliance gateway capabilities for backward compatibility of 4G and evolving that into the 5G network and collapsing networks. The cloud control plane capability with virtualization and MPLS segment routing agents that operate on our Onefinity S100 series platforms. And then our Virtuora SDN management system, orchestration and management system that blends all of these network elements together to provide this overall seamless solution with virtualization to address all these different diverse applications without having to have many different network elements, network overlays, all in one unique powerful infrastructure.
So WDM's important to 5G, but 5G transport's not just about WDM. There's a lot of other pieces, basically.
Right, exactly. It's really evolving to more of an Ethernet-based solution. Just as CPRI was more of time division-based, fixed, eCPRI, which is what 5G is using, is all Ethernet-based. So it looks like Ethernet, using Ethernet time-sensitive networking type solutions can address that, the addressing the latency sensitivity nature of the 5G networks and bring them forward into this one unique solution.
Great. Well, thank you for your time today and look forward to catching up again soon.
Okay, thank you.